Fishing, another awaited episode. So I alluded to a package that I'd gotten, and this is a company from down under that I think I want to really, there's one bait in particular that caught me. It's their squid. The plastic that they use and the way they design this lure is primarily for saltwater, but on the fall, on the rise, even swimming it, if you were to swim it across, it has this very supple, soft, pliable squid winglet, so the wings on the side of the squid actually will flutter. On the way down, they'll ribbon. On the way up, they'll ribbon. And it just, I gotta have one of those. So I've been waiting for them to show up, maybe possibly in one of my local tackle tackle shops and stores. But unfortunately, I haven't seen them yet. And I could just go on the internet and order them, but I don't know. I like to support local businesses, especially with the situation we've gone through, that if I can wait, hold out, and find it in the store and do a physical purchase, I like to do that. Plus, it gives me a better, broader sense of the color scheme and the size that I can, as far as an option goes. In the interim, though, on the website for this particular company, which is called Chasebaits, they had a sale, a big discount. They had a contest, I guess, or something like that. But they had a runners-up package, and they allowed people to purchase the runners-up package at a discount. So I grabbed that. This is a freshwater lures sampling by Chasebaits. So this is just a random sampling of some of their lures from their facility that are key towards freshwater. There's one bait in here that can only be thrown on like two of my rods because she's heavy. But let's just pull out and randomly go through what we got here. They don't have an actual like sheet of what's in it. They just have freshwater bundle, runner-up exclusives, $1 each. Quantity one, pounds, etc. With all that said, let's jump into what I got. So, first, for 5 inches, a quantity of six in purple and pearl. This is the Chasebaits fork bait. So this is basically their idea of a fork tail minnow. It does come in a plastic blister pack. Their plastic, ooh, I dropped one on the floor, did I? Nutted. Their plastic is super, super soft. Really amazing materials that they use. They do, you know, they have these really cool little eyes that they put on their stuff, so. Basically, you've got your little fluke. There's the really, really cool, mean-looking eyes. Standard little, you know, forktail fluke presentation. But it's a pretty durable, very supple plastic that they use. It's got the hook gap top and bottom, so you can throw that hook right through there. It'll pop up, and you can set it down so it'll be semi-weedless. So for all of you running flukes as your primary, where I tend to go with worms rather than flukes, ribbon tail worms, and I'll swim like a fluke. There's a lot of people that trust in flukes. It's just never been my bread and butter mainstay soft plastic lure for that style of fishing, that finesse fishing. So, 5-inch little flukes that they call, those are again purple and pearl, a little bit of blue flake in there, and they do have a dark back. So they give you that to boot. So only problem is keeping them in this package. So one thing I don't like about blisters, that's why I pretty much take everything out of these packages and put them into a Plano. 5-inch, quantity of six. That's pretty cool. Definitely get some use out of those. Next, let's just grab randoms here. Next, another blister pack. Okay, so here's your paddle tails. This is their paddle bait, they call it. It's the paddle tail swim bait. This one is in a really interesting color that they call apple juice. This is a 3-inch Kytex style in apple juice. Again, really nice, soft, spongy, supple plastic. Really, really flicky tail. Like, I'll just hold that still, and you can see it bouncing and bobbling and bouncing and bobbling. Now, I'm not sitting here wiggling my fingers like a lot of YouTubers try to do. Oh, look how good the bait is. I'm holding it as steady as I can. It just won't stop. No, seriously. Very good quality plastic. Very, reactive. Very thin on that back end, so you're going to get a lot of movement in the back. Again, they use those really mean, gnarly-looking eyeballs. It's like half-cut eyes. I like that color, apple juice. That really invites a clear water color. So we'll try that. Definitely going to have fun throwing that. Those are 3-inch size apple juice. And again, they rig it standard belly hook rig. That's cool. Definitely going to try those. They're definitely probably going to be on a short list of reorders from the company. Oh, I'll put that aside, because that next one is actually what I got this package for. Speaking of belly hooked, here's the Rip Snorter by Chasebaits. Some people have already seen this on other YouTubers. The Rip Snorter is really cool. It comes with a spare hook. It's just got like a snap. Like there's a little hole in there. You can put it through and snap that hook in. Comes with an underspin. This one is in the Mud Minnow color by the Rip Snorter, which is really cool. It runs, it could do a little sunfish color, minnow color. I like that. Interchangeable weedless vibe hook swim system. Really intricate design. I like the big thing about this, which catches my eye. I'm gonna open it later, but you can't tell, but I think there's another bait I will show you that you can tell. Chasebaits actually does, like I like, they have these appendages are three-dimensional. They flare out. The soft plastic actually molded outward. So you have a fin on each side that's going to flutter as you're dragging it through, along with your tail whipping in the back. Everything's made to be very, very natural and realistic. So that's pretty cool. Next, I've got what I got this box for. This is a 2 3/4 inch, and this is their mud bug, which is their crawfish. This is what really interests me. I'll crack this one open. So this weighs a half ounce, just under a half an ounce, 0.49 ounces. So it's just under a half ounce. Be right back. And how do you get this? Just under a half ounce. It's really amazingly lifelike. Like I said, the reason why Chasebaits caught my eye more than anything else is the realism in their materials, the ability for these baits to actually be so flexible and floppy. I mean, it reminds me very much of the Savage Gear's 3D Spider in the materials that they use and the way they try to mimic the forage. I just wish they package these. They package them bulletproof, so you're not going to lose them in the post, that's for sure. But at the same time, man, talk about difficulty opening something. Come on out. Don't rip off the clothes. Alrighty, finally. This is actually also on a weedless hook, so it's got that little weedless guard right there. And they have floating claws, floating antennae, which are really, really lifelike. It gives you a real, honest-to-God, crayfish analog with your 8 legs. It's even got the little feeding arms in the front. A lot of soft plastic companies forego that. They don't put the frill on the nose. They don't do long appendages here. They'll just do the claws, like 6 legs instead of 8. And the really cool thing about this comes with the jig. And the jig is basically, it's a stand-up jig head painted and made to look like the egg sac of a spawning cray. It's got a soft, supple tail that when you're pulling it along, this will bend over and flutter. These obviously will kick out in front when you're swimming it. And then once you set it down, these two float right up and give you that tack position, that defensive position. Really good color. This one I was lucky enough. I didn't get the chance to pick the colors. I just bought the bag. So I'm very happy that I got a decent color, because this will match most of the crayfish colors we have, is that auburn brown and and red, especially during the hot water seasons. So this is definitely going to get tossed quite a bit, and I hope to catch a couple of big, nice-sized bass on this guy for sure, for sure. Thumping tail, vibrating leg action, floating claws. Weedless hook, weighted jig head, stands up, awesome, awesome bait. This is one of the two that really caught my eyes. The other one was that squid, so I'm very happy to get this. Next to last is their version of the whopper plopper. So they have what they call the drunken mullet by Chasebaits. This one is 1 1/3 ounces, 1.3 ounces, excuse me. It's a 5 inch long, we'll just call it 5 inches. And it's an amazing whopper plopper idea. So you have, again, Chasebaits does these exposed winglets, so it gives you more realism when you're when the fish is looking up. Wide profile, wider than your typical whopper plopper by Chasebaits. Jointed, which is different than your whopper plopper standard. And the third thing that's a little different is they have an offset plopping tail. Where the whopper plopper would only have this bottom segment, they've put a little offset up here to change that plopping sound. So as it spins around, it'll give you like just a more wobbly, randomized plopping. So that's really cool. So what they call this, the offset creates slapping, wobbling motion that the fish can't resist. So it's not just the plop, 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 plop. This will also give you that dying, injured swim pattern as you're straight retrieving it. The drunken mullet combines the best attributes, creating multiple actions that the fish can't resist. On a slow retrieve, it looks like an exhausted fish. The pop tail pops and plops water and adds a bubble trail. And then the offset gives you that wobbling thing that it can't resist. So again, this is their 1/30 size, and it's, again, I said 5.1 inches and 1.03 grams, or ounces. That's really cool. Now, again, at 1.3 ounces, this has got to go on one of my big reels. I can't just throw this on my standard, heavy bass reel. I got to use the extra heavy rod to get this out there. So that's going to be limit time use because it's going to be used only on a specific rod and reel setup just out of, necessity because I don't want to break off the rod tip. And finally, the one that really has to be used on that lunker rod on my pool cue is this guy right here. This is their, what they call the prop duster. This weighs 2.2 ounces and it's a 6-inch swim bait. So I do swim bait fish a little bit when I get the chance and I have a waterway that actually is advantageous for it. Typically, the places I fish, it's not really point, there's no point to it. But jointed swim bait, this one's got what they call the prop duster. It's got a prop, just like a buzz bait, right down the middle. So you'll get this flash as you're going through, as you're swimming it. And then you've got, naturally, you've got your big, thick trebles, and then your jointed swim bait. So you can swim this through, straight retrieve it, get the plop, dead, kill it, watch it turn around. And it's got multiple hook tie areas. So you can tie up here, get more of that nose up for the prop, for the prop duster to do that thing. Or you can tie it on the front face and get more of your standard swim bait retrieve. Prop duster's glide bait, belly blade, 4X BKK hooks, soft durable fins, which are made out of a more supple soft plastic. It's not really soft plastic, but it's a more durable, softer plastic. And it's a full wire through construction, so that's pretty cool. That's important. So I know it's not going to lose the tail when I go set the hook on a big pike or big bass or what have you. That's really cool. I'm interested to see how this goes. This is in their herring pattern. We don't really have a whole bunch of herring in the lakes that I fish. But anything silver and shiny will still catch fish. It'll mimic other bait forage. So that's really cool. I'm happy to get this. I'm happy certainly to get this whopper plopper, give that a shot. But I'm most intrigued and most pleased to use this here crayfish. That's going to be fun. Chasebaits, this is their USA arm, Chasebaits USA. It's basically an Australian company, Chasebaits is, and they've always come out with some really great stuff at iCasts, and I've been following this company since it started, not too long ago, and so I'm really interested to see how this runs, how that works out, what kind of fish I can catch on it. And eventually I'm going to break down and I'm going to get that that squid, just so I can add that to my arsenal and see how that functions as a freshwater fish catcher. Anyway, I just thought I'd share... Oh, crap. I just thought I'd share this with you and, you know, see some brand baits from a not-so, you know, widely known company. I mean, obviously people see a lot of the advertisements out there. But I'm interested to see how this goes. I'm pretty sure I'm going to be pleasantly surprised in all of these baits because I trust the company quite well. And then, of course, my last video from Angler's Hall... We got that little pitching and flipping rod, or excuse me, pitching and flipping reel, so from Quantum. So I decided to go out to the store. I got myself a little Ducat 7'3" medium heavy with a really tippy tip tip. So this will be my new flipping and pitching. Key is, it's got a nice long butt end, and it's got a really, really tippy tip, but it's strong enough in the backbone for pitching and flipping. And that's pretty much one of the keys for me, personally, for flipping baits. So, Ducat rod, this was easy. It was like $100. Not bad. It was on sale, I think. They're trying to offload them. This is honestly, I think this is my first Ducat brand rod. This is their Silverado, by the way. 7 foot medium, or 7'3" medium heavy. It's got a fast tip, medium power, I think. I think it'll do well with that Quantum reel. And it, you know, me and my matching, I think that little white silver color blends in perfectly with this rod, and I like that little silver carbon fiber style color they got going for the handles, for the butt end. So, anyway, can't wait to get that out on the water. As always, thank you for spending a little bit of time with me. I keep it short and sweet. I appreciate all you guys hanging out. I've got some upcoming videos, exciting ones, not so mundane. I hope you'll enjoy. As always, from me to you, peace, be safe out there, tight lines. I'll catch you on the next cast. Take care, all you alcoholics.